Hey guys, so I'd like to discuss a question for the krok exam. So I was seeing this question. The question says that the spasm of smooth muscles of bronchi developed in a patient. Usage of activators of what membrane cytoreceptor is physiologically valid to decrease the attack? And they have given us the option adrenoreceptor. That includes alpha adrenoreceptor, beta adrenoreceptor, alpha and beta adrenoreceptor together, and N cholinoreceptor. So let's see how to solve the question and let's learn some concept. So what I'm trying to tell you, let's see the question what they have given. The patient have told that there is a contraction of the smooth muscles. So of the bronchi. So contraction of the smooth muscles of the bronchi. So what they have given us, the patient is having bronchoconstriction. Patient has what? Bronchoconstriction. So when the patient has bronchoconstriction, we need to do what? We need to dilate the bronchus. So our target is to dilate the bronchus. So let's see which receptor will do the bronchodilation. So for that purpose, I'd like to teach you a very simple thing here. All our sympathetic activation. What is that? Sympathetic activation. Sympathetic activation will lead to bronchodilation. Sympathetic activation. So that I am indicating with a plus. That will lead to what? Bronchodilation. So what happens during sympathetic activity? Sympathetic activity is nothing but your flight or fight response. Flight or fight response is what happens when you are running or when you are in a fight, when you are going for a flight. So it has a response that is sympathetic activation. Sympathetic activation is a part of autonomic nervous system. So I'm not going in depth into the autonomic nervous system. So I'm giving a overview. Autonomic nervous system is divided into sympathetic and parasympathetic. In that, sympathetic activation will lead to bronchodilation. Why bronchodilation? It's very simple. When you're fighting, for example, when you're running, you're sympathetic active. So when you're running, just understand, your body needs more oxygen supply. When your body needs more oxygen supply, bronchus has to dilate. Why bronchus has to dilate? Only if bronchus dilates, the air supply to the lungs will be more. So bronchodilation will lead to increased air supply. So we can breathe more. So sympathetic activation will lead to what? Bronchodilation. So let's see how to do this. So till now we understood the patient had bronchoconstriction. We need to do the bronchodilation. That could be done by our sympathetic activation. So this is clear, but which of the receptor acts for sympathetic nervous system? So sympathetic nervous system activation will lead to the activation of alpha adrenoreceptor as well as beta adrenoreceptor. So sympathetic nervous system act by two receptor, one is alpha, one is beta. Okay, now we need to know the locations of the alpha. Alpha is further divided into alpha 1 and alpha 2. Beta is further divided into beta 1, beta 2 and beta 3. So what are all these receptors? These receptors are activated by adrenaline and noradrenaline. So both of them together called as catecholamines. So sympathetic activity is mediated by adrenaline, noradrenaline. We are clear with neurotransmitter of the sympathetic nervous system. Here we have two types of receptor, that's alpha receptor and beta adrenoreceptor. Now we have alpha 1 and alpha 2. So alpha 1 is located in the blood vessels. Alpha 1 is located in the blood vessels. Alpha 2 is a type of presynaptic receptor. Alpha 2 is a type of presynaptic receptor. Okay. So beta 1 is located in two locations. One is our heart. The second one is our kidney. Okay. Now let's discuss about the beta 2. Beta 2 is located in three locations. Which are those three locations of the body? One is lung. The beta 2, another location is in the blood vessel. Beta 2 also located in the uterus of a female. Okay. So till now we are clear. See, spasm has there. We need to do the what? Bronchodilation. we need to do the bronchodilation because the patient had bronchoconstriction. Beta 3, let's finish off beta 3 location also. Beta 3 is majorly located in the adipose tissue. Beta 3 is majorly located in the adipose tissue. So till now we are clear. So let me remove this part if little bit here so that it will be easy for me to explain. Okay, so let's see how this works. So we know the locations. Beta 2 receptor is located in the lung, right? Beta 2 receptor is located in the lung. So activation of beta 2 receptor will lead to the bronchodilation. So smooth muscle relaxation. Smooth muscle relaxation in the blood vessel, in the uterus, as well as in the lung. So when I relax the smooth muscles of the lung, that will lead to the dilation of the bronchus. So we are done. Why not alpha adrenoreceptor? Because alpha adrenoreceptor is not located in the lung. Beta adrenoreceptor will be the answer because beta 2 is the adrenoreceptor which will cause the bronchodilation. Why not alpha 1 and beta adrenoreceptor? Not alpha 1, it's alpha and beta 1 adrenoreceptor. That is because there is no function of alpha here. So that is why we are not considering the alpha activity. So both of them together will not do only beta adrenoreceptor. So the proper answer will be beta adrenoreceptor. And the last option is given is N-cholinoreceptor. N-cholinoreceptor is a type of acetylcholine receptor. N-cholinoreceptor is a type of acetylcholine receptor which acts for parasympathetic nervous system. Parasympathetic nervous system. Okay, so sympathetic nervous system causes the bronchodilation. So patient had developed the bronchoconstriction. So we are stimulating the beta adrenoreceptor that will lead to bronchodilation. So if we know this, why we need to know? I will help you with this one here. See, if you know this one, bronchodilation is caused by stimulation of beta 2 adrenoreceptor. How to treat bronchial asthma? Bronchial asthma is a condition where there is a bronchoconstriction. We need to do the bronchodilation. So bronchodilation, how to do? By stimulation of the beta 2 receptor. So beta 2 receptor stimulants are used for the treatment of asthma. So let me tell you a little bit about the beta 2 agonist also. So what are those beta 2 agonist? Agonist is nothing but a drug which stimulates the receptor. So that is beta 2 agonist. Beta 2 agonist are used in the treatment of bronchial asthma. They are used in the treatment of bronchial asthma. There are other uses. Since I mentioned it, I will go briefly. So beta 2 agonist is further divided into two types, long acting drugs and the short acting drugs. Long acting drugs and the short acting drugs. So long acting drugs include salmeterol. Salmeterol and Femetrol, salmeterol and femetrol. Short acting, the favorite drug that is salbutamol. Salbutamol. So these are the drugs related to beta 2 agonist. So we learned a little bit of physiology about the autonomic nervous system as well as we learned about the pharmacology, how to use this, the beta 2 receptor. So beta 2 receptor stimulation will lead to what? Bronchodilation. That's why we need to do we need to activate the beta 2 adrenoreceptors in the treatment of bronchoconstriction. So this is the explanation for the question. So the answer will be beta 2 adrenoreceptor. So that is why physiologically valid to decrease the attack. So how to decrease the attack? We need to do the bronchodilation. That's very simple. Stimulate the beta 2 adrenoreceptor. That's it. Thank you guys.